Okay, this is a case where the student says she has enough labial fullness. But I'm going to concentrate here about the difference between the active lip and the flabbergasted lip. The lip is consisted of two parts, the muscular part that's inside here and some of the flabby tissue that are present here. Now, what it appears now while the patient is not speaking, that lip is touching the wax rim. But see the difference when he begins speaking. لو سمحت عد من واحد عشرة.
واحد اثنين ثلاثة أربعة خمسة.
The active lip is
سبعة ثمانية تسعة.
See the active lip had gone up, and there is an empty space in between. Other than the 90 degrees, there is no 90 degrees between the nose and the lip. But to further diagnose it and confirm it, we tell the patients to speak, and you will see that the active lip elevates the lip in another way, and then you begin to see empty spaces in between. It's not sliding over the wax, it's actually going away from it while he's speaking. عد من واحد لعشرة مرة ثانية.
واحد اثنين ثلاثة أربعة خمسة ستة سبعة.
See the active lip is away. What's touching the wax is the flabby part of the ridge. So please differentiate between them, and you need to fill in the spaces. Now, one of the problems that students have when they're thinking about, they look at the tip, they don't look at the wax in the middle. The lip fullness comes not only from the wax at the tip. You also sometimes need to fill in the wax in between the tip till the flange of the base plate. So also add in fullness here. It's not only added to the tip, you also add to the labial surface. Okay? Thank you.